This is power.
Getting superpowers in a comic book is easy. Just find the right spider. It's even easier when your next superpower is a pill away, like in Project Power. But is it even possible? What would mere humans need to suddenly have superhuman powers? The scientists we talked to agreed. In most cases, it would take a huge leap in our knowledge of biology and technology, but they still gave us their best guess on a path to get to each of four superpowers. Whether you're a cop on a beat or just someone who has the uncanny ability to find himself in a shootout, bulletproof skin is a handy power to have on the streets of New Orleans. Because as numbers and movie fight scenes remind us, the human body isn't great at handling bullets. The sources are all over the place, but a bullet only needs to travel somewhere between 148 and 197 feet per second to break skin. If it clocks in at 203, there's tissue damage. That might sound fast, but even bullets fired up in the air in celebration can come down at speeds of over 600 feet per second. So for something like this, our skin needs to be tougher. That may not be possible with keratin, the protein currently responsible for the toughness of our skin, fingernails, and hair, but our experts saw a possible replacement for it in an unlikely source, the ironclad beetle. Its exoskeleton is so tough that it can shrug off a stomp. You apparently have to drill a hole in one to display them, so it's probably good for hallway fights too. And the fibrous material behind its power is called chitin. It's like keratin, but much stronger, boosted by magnesium, calcium, zinc. And chitin is able to handle many, many times its own weight, according to scientists. But there are problems. Maybe the biggest one is that humans don't produce any. Technology does have an answer, but it's a strange one. Scientists engineered goats that can produce milk with spider silk in it, and as if that wasn't enough, they combined the resulting spider silk with leftover skin from plastic surgery to test bulletproof skin.
It's cool, right?
It could only stop bullets at less than full speed, so we should probably keep working on that pill. Some of you might be thinking, isn't being a human torch already possible? And it's true that there are occasionally suspected cases of spontaneous combustion going all the way back to the 1600s. It's usually when someone finds the burnt remains of a person in an otherwise undamaged room with no clear explanation of what caused the fire. But there are no shortcuts to superpowers. Scientists think many of those mysteries are explainable via something called the wick effect. Like a candle, clothing can soak up melted fat and deliver it steadily to a flame for a long, controlled burn. But you still need an outside source of fire, and probably an accelerant. So to pull off flame, our experts said it would take an entire new matrix of capabilities. First, you have to do something about the human body, which is relatively hard to set on fire. After all, we're full of water. It takes two or more hours at 1600 degrees to cremate one of us. So we need some accelerant on our skin. Weirdly enough, there's actually a relatively common process called ketosis, brought on by everything from alcoholism to low-carb diets, that causes the formation of a highly flammable chemical called acetone. If you could divert the electrical charge that your nervous system sends outside the body, then perhaps. But even if you somehow lit yourself on fire, there are still real problems. Humans might not easily light on fire, but we don't handle heat well. Things get bad at 104 degrees, but internal temperatures of 120 degrees can directly kill our cells. The animal kingdom only has mixed solutions. The echidna has been observed dropping its core temperature up to 45 degrees to withstand the heat of forest fires. But unfortunately for aspiring crime fighters, they only do it by going into something called a torpor, a kind of automatic shutdown mode. Pain management through painkillers would also be crucial. In the end, our experts believe that the most likely way to get to the human flame is a combination of a suit that produces fire and protects from heat, biotechnology, and extensive training in smoke avoidance. Kind of like this stuntman.
3, 2, 1, go!
Unlike some of the other powers, changing into a giant may be somewhat attainable, but there are a few catches. After all, gigantism is a naturally occurring phenomenon in animals. In individual cases, it's usually caused by a condition known as acromegaly, in which a malfunctioning pituitary gland produces too much growth hormone. And whole species can have gigantism, especially island species that had no evolutionary pressure to be small. But synthetic methods like human growth hormone are already used to grow size and muscle mass. Manipulating proteins like follistatin and myostatin could help muscles grow to superhuman size too. But here comes the first problem. HGH only increases bone length if administered before growth plates in bones fuse. In other words, before puberty. So according to our experts, instantaneous morphing would be impossible without some miraculous ability to fuse and unfuse growth plates. The second problem is that there's an inherent limit on being a giant. As size increases, the relationship between volume and surface area changes. There's relatively more volume, less surface area. That impacts the body in so many ways, from heat regulation to the amount legs can carry. It's partly why real sufferers of acromegaly face considerable health issues. One way to get around it would be to re-engineer the body, playing with different materials and proportions, get thicker. So the goal is attainable, but so far out of reach. If humans want to see the power of invisibility in action, they only need to turn their gaze towards technology and the animal kingdom. At least one sort of invisibility cloak already exists. It's composed of sheets of lenticular lenses that refract light around a target, and yeah, it seems to work. And nature gives us a few different avenues for invisibility. Squid and octopus use a combination of pigment, which has a fixed hue, and light-reflecting cells to blend into their surroundings. But the chameleon relies solely on the presence of nanocrystals in their skin cells. By relaxing or contracting layers of their skin, they rearrange those crystals, changing the way light reflects off of them, and thus, color. So according to our experts, for this to happen, instead of you just running around in your underwear, you need to borrow those ingenious adaptations. Light-reflecting crystals in your skin cells, plus the mechanic ability to move them somehow. But chameleons change colors based on moods. So experts also suggested the need for specialized photoreceptors that can scan the environment and notify the skin. So out of everything we've seen, not being seen may be the closest to reality. Invisibility, flame generation, giant growth, bulletproof skin. None are quite as easy as they may seem. And given all the violence, chaos, and explosions they cause in Project Power, it might be better to keep them safe in our comics, movies, and imaginations.
What's the most powerful animal on the planet?
Art is right that a pistol shrimp, which can create a high-velocity jet of water that's louder than a gunshot, is recognized as one of the world's deadliest creatures.
But it hits so fast.
But weirdly, it's not the only shrimp on that list. The 6-inch mantis shrimp has the world's most powerful punch, accelerating at 10,000 times the force of gravity. It's capable of shattering aquarium glass. I call dibs on
Shalom,
that power.
Shalom, all praises to Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Barakat Thum, to all the elect out there, double honor to the apostles at Great Millstone, to you brothers and sisters out there, Shalom. This is your brother Ayathun back at you with another video. And this is a great video, man. I'm excited about this video because, man, we're going to go into, Lord willing, we're going to go into technology a little bit briefly. But yeah, I'm a geek for this type of stuff, man, all this technology shit. So, man, I want to show you, brothers and sisters, how about Esau's technology, where he gets it from. All right, but first, I want to bring out a scripture. I got a couple scriptures, man. I'm just going to take y'all for the ride. You know, I got a couple queued up, but I'm sure more going to come to light. But it's going to be a short and sweet, you know, because I'm for the interest of time. So the first thing I want to bring out is Jeremiah, the 10th chapter. I'm going to start at verse 15, but you brothers and sisters should start from verse 1. Okay, and I'm going to give you the context. Basically, the Most High is talking about the idols that the other nations have created for themselves to worship. You know, Israel is the only nation on the planet Earth that has a living, breathing God or power. The powers of the other nations are dumb idols that they have to make with their own hands. So the Most High is going into that, verse 15. All right, just give you some context. Talking about the idols, they are vanity and the work of errors, and the time of their visitation they shall perish. When Yahweh Shai and the angels reappear, these are idols that are erected. They're going to perish. They're going to go away with that nuclear destruction. Verse 16, the portion of Jacob is not like them. And what's the portion of Jacob? Our portion is Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. That's our portion. Those are our powers. The portion of Jacob is not like them. Not like Buddha, not like Allah, not like Amun Ra. For he is the former of all things. So the Most High, Yahweh Yahweh Shai, created everything. The scriptures tell you. Matter of fact, let's go there. And I believe it's in Colossians. Slocky, give me 1 second. Chapter 1, verse 16. And then when you read into this, through the word of the Most High, Yahweh Shai, and the elect angels are the ones that created everything you see around you. The Most High is the Most High. He doesn't lift a finger. He employs other spirits to do his work for him. The first spirit that was created was Yahweh Shai, and then the elect was created after him. That is why they're known as the first fruits. They were the first spirits created. You see? So them being the elect and attaining, the first ones who attaining the kingdom of heaven, it's proper hierarchy because they aided Yahweh Shai in creating everything around you. Okay? The solar system, the galaxies, everything on earth. This is why Yahweh Shai told them, you have been with me since the beginning. You know? It goes deeper than what the saying says. They were literally with Yahweh Shai since the beginning of creation. So this is Colossians 1:16. For by him, Yahweh Shai, were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible. Whether they be thrones, kingdoms and rulerships. You read Revelation, it said he has the keys to heaven and hell. Okay, so he has the keys, the power to raise one kingdom and to take down another kingdom. Whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. Okay, so back to Jeremiah, the portion of Jacob, Yahweh Yahweh Shai, is not like them, not like them other idols. For he, Yahweh Yahweh Shai, is the former of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. So we are extension of those powers. So everything that they have, all the knowledge, everything that they created, we're joint heirs. They extend down to us. The Lord of hosts is his name, okay? So what I really want to get into saying that is that what prompted me to do this lesson is this information I ran into here, okay? And it says this, a man named Igor Sharkovsky assisted in over 20,000 underwater births. Eventually, he began experimenting with women giving birth in the ocean. In 1979, when preparing with his team for an underwater birth in the Black Sea, in a few feet of water, suddenly three dolphins approached a pregnant woman, pushed everyone out of the way, and took over. They scanned the length of their body up and down with sonar, because dolphins use sonar. This is why they go, eh, 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 eh. They make them sounds, because the sounds bounce off of things in the water. It might bounce off a rock, might bounce off a wall, might bounce off the ocean floor, might bounce off a predator or enemy. And determining, or according to how long it took that wave to go and come back, they can determine how close something is. They can determine the density. So after a period of time, just with sonar, a dolphin can recognize what type of animal, what type of obstacle is in his way or it's approaching. And it doesn't need an Intel chip or AMD chip. You know, it doesn't need an i7 or a computer. It doesn't need RAM. It doesn't need a hard drive. It doesn't need AI. All this processing is done within the animal's brain, all through the work of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. And the reason why, well, I got the other scripture, so let me hold off on that. It says, in a few feet of water, suddenly three dolphins approached a pregnant woman, pushed everyone out of the way, and took over. They scanned the length of her body up and down with sonar. And they do that right now. Esau, when you go, your woman's pregnant, they go and they do a sonar. You know, they do that sonar and they give you the printout. right? This has been in nature since the beginning of time. You know, going back to that scripture, Jeremiah 10, he is a former of all things, right? They scan the length of her body up and down with sonar while relaxing the mother and swimming around in circles around her. The mother gave birth to the child effortlessly, painlessly, and without fear. This began multiple projects with dolphin-assisted births that spread worldwide. And that's actually a big thing. You could Google it, dolphin-assisted birth. Now, the scripture I was thinking about is Daniel, right? So let's go to Daniel. And I believe I got that in the... okay, here we go. So this is Ezekiel, the 28 and 3. Behold, thou art wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that can hide from thee. All right, going into Esau and his wisdom. And the reason why Esau is so wise is because Esau studies. He studies the animals. Why do you think they have them different ologies? Biology, sociology, anthropology, psychology. Okay, they study these different factions of life in depth. And this is why they are so wise. So let's look into this some more. Now I want to look into is the word, hold on, did I do this right? That's the wrong one. How do I roll this slot? Give me 1 second, brothers. No, I lost it. I want to go straight to the... Here we go. 20 and 3. Okay, thou wiser than Daniel. Now, when you look this up, it should come. It says... it says intelligent, skillful, artful, cunning, subtle, wise-hearted man, right? Now, I'm looking for the word I saw earlier, because this ties into technology, into technique, actually. You know, anything that's skillful or artful is known as a technique. It goes back to techno or technology, right? So wiser than Daniel goes into what? His technology. Now, if we look up the etymology of technology right here, right, it says a discourse or treatise on an art or the arts, okay? Greek technologia, systematic treatment of an art, craft, or technique, originally referring to grammar, okay? So when you get deeper into this knowledge, Esau's technology really goes into witchcraft. Witchcraft is known as a craft or an art. It goes into witchcraft, okay? Even certain movies they bring out where they call technology witchcraft. So it says, craft or technique, originally referring to grammar, from techno, combining form of art, technique, art, skill, craft and work, method, system, and art, a system or method of making or doing things, right? So this all I'm tying everything into technology. So what I'm basically showing you that Esau's technology, he gets it from nature. He gets it by studying things that the Most High and Yahushai, you know, and the angels, us ourselves, have created. Okay? So this is knowledge, all this knowledge that we once had ourselves. When you read the book of Ezra, was going into measuring the weight of flames and this and that, the angel. Well, that's knowledge that Esau knows, and that's knowledge that we know, we were supposed to know. Okay? But the Most High opened that technology, that side up on the left-hand side to Esau. All right, so let's go into the main thing, right? So let me give you some examples of how they used animals. So there's something called aerodynamics, right? Aerodynamics is the art of creating products, things that can travel through the air with the least amount of drag, right? Like, if you like check out different vehicles. So if you check out a Porsche or a Lamborghini or a sport vehicle and you compare it to a sedan, they're shaped differently. A sedan is boxier. You know, they're giving them the sporty looks now, but they're a little bit boxier. But then you go to like a Ferrari or a Lamborghini, Aston Martin, All right. The P1, which is my favorite vehicle. You go into them vehicles, they're lower to the ground. They're more aerodynamic. They're not as boxy. They're made to cut through the wind. Now, how does Esau come up with the shapes for these different vehicles? They study animals. That's why you have certain cars that are named after animals, like the cougar, for example, the jaguar. You know, they study the animals and they shape airplanes, vehicles, after these animals so that they can cut through the wind, right? So check this out. So they have fish here because when you travel through the wind, what you're really doing is traveling through water. So what they do is they study animals in the ocean. They study animals out of the ocean. Birds, but in the ocean they study fish, because fish, there's different forms of water. The water could be a gas which we breathe in. Water could be a gas which the birds and animals fly and airplanes and all that. But water can also be in the liquid form, which is the waters. So depending on what environment you're in, you're gonna build a different type of craft, and the animals are shaped different. You know, fish have their own sort of wings, they call them fins, you know, but they're shaped differently than birds. A bird can't swim in the water, right, like a fish can, and a fish, we all know, can't swim out of the water. It'll die out of the water. So anyway, so reading on, it says, I'm just going to show you the pictures. I'm not going to read through the whole thing. Matter of fact, let me read this here. Aerodynamics and how it is measured. Aerodynamics does more than just affect streamlined racing cars. Low-resistant aircraft wings are particularly energy efficient trains, right? They build all this stuff by studying animals. The term comes from the Greek and is made up of the two words air and power, right? As a sub-discipline of physics, aerodynamics describes flow processes in gases and is therefore of great importance for a multitude of daily processes, right? So I'm not going to go into the reading. I'm just going to show you animals, right? So they mention a couple. Here, lessons that we learned from the animal world, right? The past has shown that the animal world offers a large pool of techniques that inspire people and stimulate innovation. Even in the military, they got the dragon skin, which is projectile-proof vest. How did they come up with that? They studied lizards and Komodo dragons. You know, when you read Leviathan, Leviathan skin is the same way. It's airtight. So they got all this stuff by studying animals. Where do you think Velcro comes from? Velcro, they got Velcro from studying the Geico lizard, which there's a lot of them in Florida. They're trying to figure out how they can stick to walls and walk up with no problem. They have tiny hairs underneath the pad of their feet, you know? So that's where Velcro come from. All this comes from animals. So let's go down, boom. Look, down here. The study initially focused on a completely different animal, the penguin. However, since its body structure is not suitable as a model for automotive engineering, it now serves aviation as a model for efficient flow behavior. The penguin aircraft has not been yet technically implemented due to high effort involved. You know what did I tell you? They named their crafts after certain animals. Check out the chariots. The chariots could change shape and sizes, you know? look at owls. The fascinating properties of owls. You know, the owl is extraordinarily quiet and efficient flight behavior arouses the curiosity of science. So, boom, they're making the aircraft. Where do you think they got the technology to make aircraft wings? Which a lot of those, and remember, most of the inventions that Esau got, either they stole it from nature or they stole it from Jake. Jake already came up with it. So the airplane, which Jake came up with first, the airplane body is structured just like a bird. A bird's bones are hollow and they're light so they can have a wingspan and their body doesn't drag them down. If you check out the structure of an airplane, it's hollow. The wings are hollow, just like a bird, right? So, boom, we made the point with that, all right? Now, the next thing I want to bring out, is the reason I got my man here, right? Israel by Superman, because the Israelite man is a real Superman. Let me bring that out real quick, right? That's Psalms 82 and Psalms 82 and 6. Psalms 82 and 6, where I might as well just go to it. Let's take 82. Verse 6, it says, I have said ye are gods, and all the children, and all of you are children of the Most High. So we're gods. In other words, we're all angels. We have all, we're fallen angels. We don't have our Superman powers. We're like Clark Kent, right? So with that, I want to show you something. So the Superman, his name is known as Clark Kent when he's in his fallen angel body, right? Now let's look at the word Clark. I got to give a shout out and credit to my man out there in Holland, Yama'ala. You know, he put me onto this. The word Clark means clerk or priest from the Hebrew. So who are the real Clark Kents? You Israelites, you brothers out there, you Israelites, the 12 tribes of Israel are the real Clark Kents, because we are the real supermen and our powers have been taken away. We just read in Psalms 82, I have said ye are gods, but ye shall die like men. Clark Kent, Superman as Clark Kent, he was getting his ass kicked, all right? And he could die, bleeding. But as Superman, in his angelic form, he could stop a bullet, right? So if you look here in etymology.online.com, Clark, also Clark, surname. I did another video going to the surname. Look that up. From common Middle English alternative spelling of clerk. So let's look up clerk. Now, if you remember, when you go into churches, what do you have? You have a clergy of what? Priests. Clerk, a man ordained in the ministry, a priest. An ecclesiastic, from Old English cleric and Old French clerk, a clergyman, priest, scholar, student, right? Now, did not the Lord say that he's going to raise up the sons of Israel to be prophets and priests unto him? So you brothers out there that are Israelites, you are the real Clark Kents. You are the real supermen. Now, us being supermen, the Most High gave us something called that Esau doesn't have, hence his name. I saw wasted his ways. We have something called pigmentation or melanin. Okay? Melanin. Now, let me show you something, brothers. Melanin, do you know that Esau is creating technology based off melanin? Esau's most advanced technology, his bionic weapons, his bionic suits that he puts on his soldiers to turn them into super soldiers. As you see in the movies where they put on these suits and they can run fast as hell. Vin Diesel just did a movie. I forgot the name of it, with nanotechnology. All this science they're coming up with, nanotechnology, repairing blood cells. If you remember Batman, he had a suit when he applied electricity, the cape got stiff so he could fly. Yo, brothers, they got all that is power that we have as Israelites. You know, we don't know how to use it yet. We don't have it yet because we're not in that angelic form. But Esau is tapping into it on the left-hand side. And what he realized is that power comes from melanin, right? High-tech melanin might help put technology inside our bodies. Now, you see here, they got Arnold Schwarzenegger, the Terminator, with his metallic hand, okay? Let's read down. A form of melanin could help integrate technology into our bodies. Though actual robot arms might be a stretch, we have a complicated relationship with melanin, the natural chemical pigment that gives color to our eyes, hair, and skin. It protects our skin from harmful radiation from the sun, but can also lead to cancer. There's also a whole matter of discrimination, blah, blah, blah. Let me read down. So there's a certain type of melanin that they don't teach us about. It's called eumelanin, right? A type of melanin known as eumelanin is electrically conductive, meaning it could be a great material for biotechnology. Since our bodies are already familiar with the stuff and it's a biodegradable substance, but this kind of melanin is unfortunately not quite conductive enough to be useful right now. Electricity just doesn't flow as well across it as we need to, so what they're going to do is grab it and they're going to amplify it in their laboratories. The reason why we can't use it now, we just read, is because we're in our fallen state. When we get in our new bodies, spoken about Thessalonians, when we're changed in the twinkle of an eye, we're going to be able to run without getting tired. We're going to be able to fly. We're going to be able to use all those elements to the fullest potential. All right? So we're literally going to have spiritual power. Spiritual power. It says, scientists had been working on solutions like mixing melanin with other substances, right? So boom, they're trying to capitalize on the melanin. Look at that. The research, which appears today in the journal Frontiers of Chemistry, shows how they did just that. It is based on a process called annealing, which basically heats materials to strengthen them, usually on metals and glass, right? The treatment effectively organizes the melanin molecules into a more efficient arrangement without altering the makeup or structure. Meaning, brothers, we will literally be able to shape shift. We can create weapons. He's able to create, solid shapes and stabbing weapons, as he was explaining in Terminator 2, right? So check this out, my brothers. Now, this is someone, this is one of Apostle Gabar's favorite scripts, and one of mine also. But I used to bring this out all the time in the school. Hold on. I thought I was spelled wrong. Verse 15, Isaiah 41:15. Fear not, thou worm, O Jacob. Why are we a worm? Because we have no protection. A worm cannot protect itself. It's helpless. I will help thee, save the Lord and the Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Verse 15. How is he going to help us? Isaiah 59. When enemies shall come in as a flood, he shall raise up a standard against them, which we always teach you, brother. That's that spiritual power. Okay? Here's another scripture. I will help thee, save the Lord and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, Yahushua. Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. The word teeth means you bite and you tear apart. Micah, you know, we'll be like a dew. We'll be on the other nations like dew and should tear them like a lion tears its prey. Thou shalt thresh the mountains, governments, and beat them down, silly, and beat them small and shall make the angels as chaff. How are we going to do that? With spiritual power. With spiritual power. Okay? So what else do I have here? The pigment in our skin could be used to make electrical body implants. So you see that, brothers and sisters? The Most High has given us God. We are gods on this earth, okay? And we have powers that we're not able to tap into yet, right? Look at this. Clumps of eumelanin, a type of melanin, are typically made up of millions of disordered sheets layered on top of one another. So what Esau is trying to figure out, he's working with, is how to organize the melanin, okay? He can rearrange them to fit whatever he like. And he actually has something called melanin weapons. These are melanin weapons based off of melanin. This is where the nanotechnology comes from, and this high technology they got. Boom, boom, boom. So that's all I'm gonna read on that, man. You brothers can look up this eumelanin. You know, look at that. What is that? The nano chip, that chip that Elon Musk wants to put in our brain, and all them chips they have now that can stop Parkinson's disease and all these different diseases is based off melanin. This is why Jake can run faster, think smarter, think harder. They're better at everything because we have that super weapon, which is that melanin, which Esau does not have. This is why Esau needs the help. This is why Esau needed the blessing of the sword, okay? Because without it, he's weak. This is why the scriptures say, I made thee small among the heathen in the book of Obadiah. The word small means insignificant. The Most High took away his melanin, which is a detrimental, okay? It shows you, when you read Isaiah, was it 34? It's either Isaiah. I'm sorry, brother. Matter of fact, let me just get it because it's been so long since I read this one, right? I know it in my head, though. It's, yeah. There we go. It is Isaiah 34:7. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Talking about the missiles. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea, Esau, and upon the people of my curse of judgment. So it shows you the Most High truly did curse his devil without that pigmentation. You know, they look, because they're weaklings without that. Okay, So anyway, you brothers, boom, boom, boom. Did I miss anything here? Oh, yeah. Matthew 6. Let me bring this out. It's one example of something we'll be able to do. Matthew 6 and 27, right? Going into spiritual power. It says, which of you by taking thought can add one cubit unto her stature? So that shows you, brothers, when we get that spiritual power, all we're going to have to do is think. Think and it'll manifest whatever we're thinking, because we're going to have the power to, we're going to have the power to manipulate elements, manipulate our melanin, manipulate the elements of the world, which is true power. And this is a level that Esau wants to get to, but he hasn't, because with his technology in a process, he's got to destroy the earth. He's got to dig stuff up. He's got to destroy people. He's got to destroy land, create waste products. Okay. So that's the power he has on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, the animals, Jake, we have all that technology already built in us without, and it's all synergistic. It all works with the elements of the world. It doesn't destroy the world, nor the oceans, nor the air, nor the earth. You see? Let me get one scripture. One last scripture. Isaiah 40 and 31. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint, baby. So all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. I hope this lesson was edifying. Brothers, shalom. Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai.